Hello everyone, myself A.S. Falmari, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In the last video, we have discussed de Moivre's theorem and few examples. In this video also, we consider some examples on how to evaluate the powers of a complex numbers. The learning outcome is, at the end of this session, students will be able to evaluate powers of complex numbers using de Moivre's theorem. Now consider the first example. Evaluate 1 plus sin alpha plus I cos alpha divided by 1 plus sin alpha minus I cos alpha bracket power n. Solution. Now here we use one trick that we write 1 as sin square alpha plus cos square alpha. And in this one, we replace this plus by minus I square. We know that I square is the value of minus 1. So minus minus will nothing but again plus. Now writing this plus as minus of I square. Now applying the result of A square minus B square is equal to A minus B into A plus B. We get it as sin alpha plus I cos alpha into sin alpha minus I cos alpha. To get this numerator, now let us add sin alpha plus I cos alpha on both sides. After adding, we get it as 1 plus sin alpha plus I cos alpha is equal to sin alpha plus I cos alpha plus, in the first bracket, sin alpha plus I cos alpha into sin alpha minus I cos alpha. Now here we can see that it is possible to take sin alpha plus I cos alpha common from these two terms. After taking this term common, we get sin alpha plus I cos alpha inside the bracket into, now the first term left as a simple 1 plus, from the second one, the left quantity is sin alpha minus I cos alpha. Now, in order to have this given quantity, we can see that this is what a denominator. Let us divide this whole equation by 1 plus sin alpha minus I cos alpha. We get 1 plus sin alpha plus I into cos alpha divided by 1 plus sin alpha minus I into cos alpha is equal to. Now this will be removed. We are left with only sin alpha plus I cos alpha. Now here we have to take the nth power of this quantity. But if I observe on the right hand side, here we have to definitely apply de Moivre's theorem. But the first term is sin 1. So we convert it to cos by using the relation between them sin and cos, like sin alpha is equal to cos of pi by 2 minus alpha plus I into, and writing this cos alpha as sin of pi by 2 minus alpha. Now taking n power on the both sides, we get 1 plus sin alpha plus I cos alpha divided by 1 plus sin alpha minus I cos alpha bracket raised to n is equal to, on the right hand side, this quantity is present inside the bracket, cos of pi by 2 minus alpha plus I sin of pi by 2 minus alpha bracket raised to n. Now this is what a structure of a de Moivre's theorem. Let us apply de Moivre's theorem. After applying de Moivre's theorem, we get it as cos of n into the bracket pi by 2 minus alpha plus I sin of n into the bracket pi by 2 minus alpha. This is the simplified form of this complex number. Let us consider one more example. Evaluate cos theta plus I sin theta divided by sin theta plus I cos theta bracket raised to 4. Solution. The given expression is cos theta plus I sin theta divided by sin theta plus I cos theta bracket raised to 4. Taking the separate power of numerator and denominator, we get it as cos theta plus I sin theta bracket raised to 4 divided by sin theta plus I cos theta bracket raised to 4. Let us call it as equation number 1, and evaluating numerator and denominator separately, consider first numerator. Cos theta plus I sin theta bracket raised to 4 is equal to, immediately by application of de Moivre's theorem, we get it as cos 4 theta plus I sin 4 theta. Consider the denominator sin theta plus I cos theta bracket raised to 4. Let us write down this sin theta as cos of pi by 2 minus theta plus I into, and writing cos theta as sin of pi by 2 minus theta bracket raised to 4. Now applying de Moivre's theorem, we get cos of 4 into the bracket pi by 2 minus theta plus I into sin of 4 into the bracket pi by 2 minus theta. Now after multiplying by 4 inside the bracket, we get it as cos of 2 pi minus 4 theta plus I into sin of inside the bracket 2 pi minus 4 theta. Now pause this video and simplify these two terms. I hope that all of you have simplified it. Simplifying these two terms is nothing but applying the trigonometric identity cos of a minus b, which is nothing but cos a cos b plus sin a sin b, and sin of a minus b for this term, which is nothing but sin a into cos b minus cos a into sin b. Now applying this trigonometric result for these two terms, we get cos 2 pi into cos 4 theta plus sin 2 pi into sin 4 theta plus I into inside the bracket sin 2 pi into cos 4 theta minus cos 2 pi into sin 4 theta. Now the value of cos 2 pi is 1, so 1 into cos 4 theta is cos 4 theta. We know that the value of sin 2 pi is 0, therefore second term vanishes, plus I into the bracket. Now the value of sin 2 pi is 0, therefore this term is also vanishes, and this is minus. The value of cos 2 pi is 1, so it is minus sin 4 theta, and this I as it is. Now applying the corollary number 2 here, we can write this minus as a power minus 1 for the term cos 4 theta plus I sin 4 theta bracket raised to minus 1. Now substituting the expression for numerator and denominator in the equation number 1, we get, now this is what the equation number 1, substituting the expressions, we get it as cos 4 theta plus I sin 4 theta divided by cos 4 theta plus I sin 4 theta bracket raised to minus 1. In the denominator, this quantity is present with negative power, means we have to write it in the numerator with positive sign. Therefore, we get this product. Both the terms are same with 1 as a power. We can write it as cos 4 theta plus I sin 4 theta bracket raised to 2. Now, again applying de Moivre's theorem, we get cos of 8 theta plus I sin 8 theta. Let us consider one more example. If x plus 1 upon x is equal to 2 cos theta, then prove that 2 cos r theta is equal to x to the power r plus 1 upon x to the power r. Solution. Now we have a given relation is x plus 1 upon x is equal to 2 cos theta. So in order to solve such a kind of an equation, so every time our aim is to convert it to a polynomial. In order to convert it to a polynomial, we multiply it by x. We get it as x square plus 1 upon x into x is 1 is equal to 2x cos theta. Rewriting it, we get x square minus 2x cos theta plus 1 is equal to 0. Now we can consider it as a quadratic polynomial in x, and it has two roots. The roots of this quadratic polynomial are obtained by using the formula x is equal to minus b plus minus under root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Here a is 1, b is minus 2 cos theta, and c is 1. Now substituting all the values of a, b, c in this formula, we get it as x is equal to minus into the bracket minus 2 cos theta plus minus under root of minus 2 cos theta bracket square minus 4 into 1 into 1 upon 2 into 1. Now simplifying this, we get it as, now this minus minus will become plus 2 cos theta plus minus under root of minus 2 cos theta bracket square is nothing but 4 cos square theta minus 4 into 1 is simple 4 divided by 2 into 1 is 2. Now from this under root sign, we can take 4 outside, and under root of 4 is 2. Again from this we can take 2 common and cancel with the denominator, so we are left with only cos theta plus minus under root of cos square theta minus 1. Again, writing cos theta as it is plus minus under root of, we know that cos square theta minus 1 is nothing but minus of sin square theta. It is equal to cos theta as it is plus minus. We know that under root of minus sin square theta is nothing but I sin theta. Now it has two roots. One is cos theta plus I sin theta and another is cos theta minus I sin theta. Now let us consider the positive root. X is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta. Now taking rth power on both sides, we get x to the power r is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta bracket raised to r. Applying De Moivre's theorem, we get it as cos r theta plus I sin r theta. Call it as equation number 1. Consider the quantity 1 upon x to the power r, which is nothing but x to the power minus r, and x is nothing but cos theta plus I sin theta and bracket raised to minus r. Now applying the De Moivre's theorem directly, we get it as cos of r theta due to the minus n, we get here minus I sin of r theta. Now let us call it as equation number 2. In order to calculate the given quantity, we have to add equation number 1 and 2. After adding, we get it as x to the power r plus 1 upon x to the power r is equal to cos r theta plus I sin r theta plus, in the next bracket, cos r theta minus I sin r theta. Now we can see that the second and fourth one are same terms with opposite sign. We have to remove them, and the first one and the third term is the same one. So we can write it as 2 times cos r theta. Hence proved.